Yeah, it's 6:33, so I just vacuumed the ceiling and the sides and everything, and I didn't go feed the other cat yet, or my cats yet, because I'm going to move everything back, and I think by 7, then the dryer should not be warm anymore, so that's when I'll feed all the cats. So I'm moving everything back, so I'm going to move the table back. At least I'm getting muscle. So I'm going to put my music on again. Cleaning is fun. Gets your mind off stuff. That's why it's all I could do right now. We will clean off this table. I'm going to stretch. Just wondering what I should do. Because I got to put the chair, one chair back, and I got to push that back in. So yeah, I'll move the stretching post. And then I gotta vacuum this side of the room. And I'm gonna do that after. Can't see everything, but I basically went underneath. That's a lot of muscle work. So it's weird because all that I've been doing on today is eating and washing hand Montana and moving stuff around in a vacuum and doing laundry and that's and cat looking after the cats and cat sitting is part of that. So it's really not a lot of, it feels like it's not a lot that I'm doing, but It is, because they're moving stuff around. And I did the three loads of dishes. I almost fell asleep. Oh, and last night I started watching Titanic. So, yeah. I don't know, I still like that show. I just don't like Leonardo DiCaprio anymore. Because of who he is, but he's still a good actor. He just does. He only dates girls when they're young, and as soon as they get to a certain age, even if they live together, he dumps them. And a lot of his exes have talked a lot about him like that, so he just wants to keep being with young girls, and as soon as they get old, that's it. And to me, that's a douchebag. So, I don't really like that. I don't even know why he even bothers. I mean, if you look at him now, he's not that good looking compared to when he was in Titanic, but oh well, I never date him. Not now, anyways. So, yeah, but I still love the story of the Titanic, and, I got you, most of you guys know I'm a history buff, so it's part of history, and I love a lot of ghost stories, and, lots of, what do you call it, ocean shows, even though I hate the water, I still watch it. So I'm surprised this is a short video, because it's easy moving stuff around. So when I get back from feeding the cat, and then transfer my laundry over, feed my cats, I'm going to start, because I know they're not going to eat if I, actually I might feed my cats first before I go do the other cat. So then, because as soon as I turn on the vacuum, they're going to leave. All the cat just will be, ain't she cute? I'd be so lost without her. I love you, Josephine. She's like, why is my scratching post over here? I think I might move it around. I just kind of like it where the spot that I have it, because it's close to the window. But, and I thought Speckles would go up on the couch and get to the thing, but maybe she might like it on this side. Maybe I'll do that. See if she still goes in there. Instead of putting the chair there. Because I don't really have people over anymore. If I do games night, it'll be like next month. Most likely. So many people are busy during the summer anyways. So it's like, I'm just focused on getting my place together. And so I'm like, I don't really have time for things. Because I have doctor's appointments. And then I have to clean and get things sorted. Well, I still have to sleep because of my condition, so probably when I vacuum this spot, I'm probably gonna go watch Hannah Montana again, and eat my salad, transfer laundry over, and spend time with the other cat, then come back and take a nap, because by then it'll be like 8 or 9 probably, because like 7 I think. I haven't taken a nap yet. I almost did. I'm drinking lots of water. So, yeah, that's how I keep track of how much water I drink. I put in a Pepsi bottle. That's 1 liter. So, as long as I drink one of these every few hours, then I know I'm getting lots of water because it's 1 liter. And I only have 2 cups of coffee when I wake up. And then I have this. I'm probably going to have my energy drink next. Because I know I'll be tired and that'll probably put me to sleep. Because it always puts me to sleep. But then after I wake up, I feel energized. So. I hate the taste of water though. That's why I used to put cucumbers in water. But then cucumbers don't last long. That's the problem. I mean, I guess I gotta look that up. How to make cucumbers last long. But yeah, I'm getting a little tired. But I don't want to go take a nap until at least I vacuum this side. And if I end up not going back to transfer my laundry over and just eat here and then fall asleep. That's fine too, because then I'll just watch Titanic. But I haven't seen Hannah Montana in a long time, so I'm on season two when she meets Jake, Jake Ryan. So, yeah, we'll see. And I hate the taste of water, so I drink it really, really fast. So then that way I'll drink it. I think a liter is only like 2 cups though, or 2.5 cups. I have to look that up. And then hopefully, because I vacuumed, vacuum the filming area, I'll be motivated to do other videos. That's what the goal is for. So that's why I'm trying to do as much vacuuming as I can today, and then I'll just do other videos all at once because there's like lots of videos I want to do. Like I said, I want to talk about my ex, and then I want to talk about the good things about and the bad things about having a disability and condition, like medication, and just more informational video kind of thing. Reasons why it's awesome being single. Stuff like that. So, if you guys have any other suggestions for videos for me to do, please let me know because I'm starting to run out of ideas. And I would kind of want to keep it fresh. Even if only 8 people watch one video, I'm happy with that because, like I said, this YouTube is more for like my video diary. I just never expected people to like donate, and quite a few people have, so that kind of encourages me to do more videos. And yeah, and the friendships I've made, so it's good. Oh, and if you guys don't want to hear about crime videos, there's this new channel that I found, Brought in Mingo, if that's what it's called. I'll leave the description and the link in the description for the video that I'm watching now. But there was a YouTuber who was doing a live, and she got burnt alive on live stream on YouTube in like 2000 and something, and I think it was 2002. And yeah, it's pretty crazy hearing those things. And like, it got cut off before you could see everything, but you could still hear everything. So I'm like, wow, I never knew that. But it's an interesting story. And if you guys don't want to watch it, if you guys want to know what happened, because you're a YouTuber and you're worried, because I was like, uh-oh, I'm worried that people are going to find out where I live because of my IP or whatever. But it turned out that's the ex-husband that lit her on fire. So it wasn't a viewer or anything like that. But I'll link the thing below. But there are like a lot of people on YouTube that have died on YouTube, and there's a lot of videos where they did live streaming. There's one very popular video, I can't remember where I saw it, but the girl was doing a live stream when she was driving, and they weren't paying attention, obviously, and they're joking and partying or whatever. And then they got into an accident, and they was filming the whole thing. I'm like, wow, they recorded their own death. That's pretty crazy. I don't remember where I saw that, but I'm pretty sure if you put it in YouTube, it'll come up. But yeah, it's just pretty crazy, some lives. And I think that's one reason why I don't want to do live anymore though, because technically I think somebody could find out where you live from your IP address if you're on for a long time or something. So I don't know, I'm kind of iffy now about doing lives, because I was thinking about doing it once a month, but if you just do a video and you upload it, I think it's fine. But Because technically you don't know for sure, like, where I am sometimes. So, hopefully nobody will, like, ever find out where I live through my IP address. But I'm not that popular. Although I do have stalkers and crazy people that follow me, and I block them all. So that's why I'm very picky. Like, when people leave me comments, and it's like they keep calling me beautiful, and after I keep telling them not to call me beautiful or keep hitting on me, I block them now because I've had stalkers all my life. Even when I was in elementary school, high school, I actually had one guy follow me when I was in high school home every day, and he'd actually tried attacking us, but he didn't get away with it. So yeah, it was pretty scary back then. So now since I've seen that, I'm kind of thinking, so I might not do lives. I'm debating about that. I'm kind of discouraged with lives too, because whenever I do lives, people don't come on, even though they say that they want lives. So I think it's just easier just for me to, like, do a video and upload it like I have been, rather than doing lives. Because, like, if people want to talk to me, they could always go to my Facebook. Like I said, Phantom Stories is on Facebook. Or you could email me, because that's the easiest way to get a hold of me if you ever want to talk to me or whatever. But yeah, I don't think I'm going to do a live. So I'm pretty sure I'm not going to do a live anymore after I've been hearing these videos. Not just the one, even though it's not her. It was her husband. Still, you never know. Like, there's a lot of people who have been killed by their viewers or by their fans, and it's like, I want to take that risk. So unfortunately, I'm not doing lives anymore. Just to warn you guys. If I do, I might do a Zoom, but then you have to be invited into Zoom, and then with Zoom, you could actually see the person from their face, so then that way I can choose who's watching, rather than when I'm on live YouTube, I can't pick and choose who's watching, and then they could say stuff. In the last live that I did, I kept having this guy kept telling me how much he liked me and stuff like that. And he's like in California, and I'm like, dude, you're in California, man. You're too far away. So yeah, live is just not for me. I'm not gonna do live again. If I do live, it'll be on Zoom. So if you guys want me to do Zoom, let me know. I might do Zoom again once a month. Because when I first started doing live, I mean, before I was doing live, I was doing Zoom once a month. But with YouTube, when you get so many subscribers, people could donate money through Super Chat. So if it ever ends up to where I get so many subscribers, so I could finally earn money through Super Chat, then I might. But then they'll be short lives. They won't be like more than a half hour. So nobody could find out where I live and stalk me, because I've had enough stalkers in my lifetime. I think that's one reason why I don't like going out anymore, because even the other day when I went out to Walmart, I had somebody bothering me. They're like, "Oh, you're so cute, blah blah blah." I say, and then there was a guy that I liked. But then I was just like, "Oh, he's just going to do the same shit." So that's why I don't really like being outside right now. Yeah, it's just really awkward outside, and people are awkward, and it's just weird. And I've had so many bad experiences with dating. Pretty sure, yeah, because I told you guys before that I met up with two different guys in a public place, and because I want to go home with them, they tried to beat me, but then because I hit them and ran away, I never heard from them again, so that was good. And then, so that's what I always do, because then that way you're like standing your ground. And people are like, "You shouldn't do that, you should just run away." I'm like, "They're just gonna go after you, but if you stand your ground." I mean, they weren't that big of people anyways. And then the last guy was a guy that I knew that I had a crush on for a long time. And I was friends with his mom, and then he ghosted me because I told him I had dentures, even though we had met and we flirted and whatever, but then he ghosted me. So after that, I was just like, fuck this shit. I don't have time for this crap. We'd like talk like for hours, and then like even the guy, the bartender from Victoria, especially him, he really pissed me off. This was before my last ex. But he's like, oh yeah, I like you. And then we talked for like almost, we literally talked all night long. He sent me naked photos, which I didn't keep. I didn't send any, of course. But he sent me photos, and I was just like, and then all of a sudden, because I talked to him too much, he's like, oh, I don't want to, I don't think we should meet up and be friends or anything because you seem too clingy. And I'm like, but we talked all night that night, so how is that any different than when we were, I'm not a convenience girl. So, yeah, I'm just done with guys right now. Unless if somehow I end up meeting somebody and they're different, who knows? Like, maybe somebody might contact me through YouTube and that I like, and maybe they're different, but like I said, I'll always have an open mind, but I'm not looking for a relationship. I prefer being single. I've already tried dating, and that was more hell than it was worth. And it just got my hopes up, so I'm not putting myself through that again. And if God wants me to be with somebody, he'll bring him to me. So that's the way that I look at it now. Before, it was different because I just was like a player, but now that I'm like 42 with this condition, it's just hard to live. Sometimes it's hard to do day-to-day things, so adding a relationship on top of that is hard, and there's a lot of guys I want to see every day, and I've always been the type where I only want to see you once a month. So I've been in a lot of long-distance relationships, and a lot of them were good. Like, a lot of them were really good, but it was just too heartbreaking when we broke up that I can't go through that again. So sadly, yeah. Anyways, I guess I'm just talking to make this video a little longer. So now I'm going to feed my cats and then go feed the cat that I'm cat sitting, turn the dryer on. Then come back and vacuum this area, and then when I vacuum the chairs, I'll show you guys how I do that. I'm thinking of putting the scratching post there now, because Josephine seems to like it, but I might just move it closer to the light. But then I gotta push my table in, so that's the only problem. So maybe I won't. I'll just have it closer to the table than to the couch, maybe. I don't know, I'll figure it out. If you guys have any suggestions how I should have it, let me know. But I have to move this table in, otherwise when I film, because I film by the Christmas tree and Freddy Krueger stuff here. So when I film, if the table's in the way, like it is now, then there's not a lot of space, so I have to move this table back. So, yeah. I usually put a chair where the scratching post is, and then I move the table in. So I think I'll just do that, but at least I'm getting there and keeping busy. So I hope you enjoyed I hope you guys enjoyed my stories, because I got a lot of stories. I almost feel like writing a book of all the times that I met people, and like dated people, and like got stood up by people on the phone, and guys that I still have a crush on that I can't find anymore. There's actually one guy from, his name was Soggy Bottoms on Yahoo, and we talk on the phone, like, all the time, and then I moved, so then I lost contact with him, and His name was Graham, but he was really good looking. I actually have a photo of him. So maybe I'll do a video of different guys that I'm looking for that I had a crush on, because I'm kind of curious. Like the guy from Time Out Video Stores, Greg. I still can't find him. So it's weird too, because I actually wrote to the store. I wrote him a letter with Donald Duck, Donald Duck postcard. And then he contacted me, and then we became friends again. So that was weird, because, but then I didn't hear from him for like, I guess almost 6 months before I sent the letter. But it turned out that he was a race car driver, and he ended up getting married. But it was cheaper for him to get medical here than it is in the States. So whenever he came here, he talked to me. But then the girl ended up leaving after 6 months, and she's trying to get all his money. I'm like, but I'm still trying to find out where he is, or if I could find him. But I don't remember his last name. But I do know he looks like, kind of looks like the guy Dawson from Dawson's Creek. That's why I was into him. I even told him that too. I'm like, do you look like Dawson? But yeah, it is weird. Like, he's met everybody in my family, and he'd always come over and hang out, and we weren't dating, but I was with somebody usually at whenever he was in town, or he was with somebody. So it's kind of interesting. I think his last name was Donnelly, Greg Donnelly, but I tried looking on Facebook and stuff like that. I almost was going to get a private investigator when I was like in my 20s to see if I could find him. But I couldn't afford it, so it was like, oh, yeah. It's kind of funny. I wonder what happened to him. But it's like, everybody's like, oh, are you guys dating? I'm like, no, but I have a huge crush on him, but I can't tell him that. But he's met my cousin, he's met my grandma, he's met my mom a few times, he's met my doctor brother. Yeah, it's just weird how many people he's met in my family. One of my best friends, and we never dated. Because I was with somebody, or he was with somebody. So I don't know, maybe I will hire a private investigator one day. I'm kind of curious to what happened to him. But yeah, so if anybody knows the store Time of Video Stores, it was a video store in Port Coquitlam, in Vancouver, in Port Coquitlam, BC. Let me know. I don't know. Who knows? Maybe somebody watching knows them. So anyways, like I said, I gotta go feed my cats, and then I go transfer laundry over. The dryer should be not that warm now. It's been about an hour. And hopefully I can stay up at least till 9 or 8. What time is it now? Oh, it's only 7. Yeah. So hopefully I can stay up till 9 and then take a nap. I do want to take the cats out tonight, but if I don't end up doing it, it's not the end of the world. But Speckles was it yesterday, so. Anyways, I'll talk to you guys later. Hopefully you guys enjoy my stories. Let me know. and yeah, I have a lot of stories still to tell. Maybe I'll make a whole video on that. I've already talked about like a few guys that I've dated, and guys that I'm still in love with and stuff like that in like previous videos. That's not just based on that, but I might put them all into one. We'll see. So I'll talk to you guys later. Like, comment, share, subscribe. And when I get back, after I'm done vacuuming, we'll move stuff around together. If I'm still awake. So we'll find out here on Phantom Stories. Thanks again for your support, and I hope you're cleaning with me, or this inspires you to clean. Welcome to my haunted world, XOXO OG Upper Ghost.